Promises work exactly like in real life. When your kid promises you to do the homework by the end of the day, either by the end of the day, he or she finishes this promise by doing the homework or fails. In this example, we can consider doing the homework as a deferred process, and the result of this process is initially unknown. This process may be finished, but also may fail. The promise represents a placeholder for this result. Promises are very useful tools when working with asynchronous code. Promise represents a deferred process in one of three steps. Pending. The promise starts with this state because the value of the deferred process is yet unknown. Fulfilled. The promise is filled with the value returned from the deferred process. Rejected or failed state is set when there was an exception during the deferred execution. State transitions of the promise look like this. Once the promise is fulfilled, it cannot be refulfilled, rejected, or moved back to pending. You go from the pending state to either fulfilled or rejected, and you are done. The promise is settled. It is a very simple model where you can entirely trust to the value received from a promise. There is no situation when you read value from the promise and then, couple loops later, some exception or error happens and the promise becomes rejected. Now let's write some code to better understand the idea of promises. I've already installed React.php promise component. The advantage of using promises is that they allow us to separate the deferred process from its consumer. Instead of passing around the callbacks, we provide a promise to the consumer. Then the consumer can perform some actions when the promise resolves. We'll create a fake HTTP function that uses callbacks, and then we'll refactor it using promises. Our function accepts an URL, method, success callback, and error callback. Inside we create a variable for response, and then check. If response contains something, we call success callback with response. Otherwise, we call error handler with an exception. Let's call our function and see it in action. We call it HTTP, pass in URL, the method, success callback that expects a response, and an error callback that expects an exception. We just echo both response and error. We run our code, and because response is null, the error callback has been called, and it prints message no response. Let's set the response and see that it was passed inside the success callback. Now let's refactor this function to use promises instead of callbacks. At first we change the function signature, we don't need these callbacks. To handle the result of an asynchronous process, we create a deferred object. Then, depending on the response value, we either resolve or reject. And at the end, we return a promise of this deferred. Now we can simplify the call here. We only pass an URL and a method. Promises have a built-in method to handle fulfilled and rejected states. Method then accepts two handlers. The first one is called when the promise is fulfilled. The second one is called when the promise is rejected. We are done. We have refactored to use promises instead of callbacks. Let's run it to make sure that it still works like before. We see that the response data was printed. When we remove the data, we get message no response. Another advantage of using promises is that we can use a return statement in our code and chain the promises. For example, we can add one more than call and uppercase the response. This modified value will be passed into the next handler in the chain. Promises protect us from uncaught exceptions. For example, if we throw an exception in one of the handlers, it will be caught. Also, our last then method can be rewritten. We can remove the second argument for error handler and use otherwise method at the end of the chain. Then we pass error handler inside otherwise method. Let's recap. With promises, we can write asynchronous code in synchronous way. Instead of using callbacks, the deferred process returns a promise that can be used as a placeholder for the result of this process. Then we can attach handlers to this promise and perform some actions when the process is done. We have learned about then and otherwise methods and their basic usage. In asynchronous code, promises and streams are used to organize the data flow. When we need a single value from a deferred process, we use promises. When we are dealing with some API, which is continuously reading or pushing the data, we use streams.